This video is sponsored by AEduce. Hey guys, once again, welcome back to the new video. In this video, we are going to create an awesome looking neon lighting effect that is super easy to create inside of After Effects without using any third-party plugins. You can use this animation in any video editing project and make your videos much better. I am Vikas from Skyline Motions, and without any further ado, let's get started. Alright, so here we are in Adobe After Effects, and if you are new on this channel, please hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell notification for more interesting videos, and also hit the like button if you like this video. And now let's start by creating a new composition. So click on this new composition button, or you can just go over here and take a new composition, and this is gonna be our main composition, so you can call it anything. I'm gonna call it main. Set the size of this composition 1920 in width, 1080 in height. You can go with 4K as well. And now we have to select a frame rate. So in this case, I am using this 30 frame per second, but you can go with 60 frame per second for smooth animation or 24 frame per second for cinematic. But I'm using 30 frame per second, which is good enough for me. And now let's set the duration of this composition. So I'm gonna set the duration maybe 3 seconds long, which is good enough for one slide. You can set this duration according to you, but 3 seconds is good enough. And now you can select any background color, it doesn't really matter, and then hit OK. After that, we have to create a black background, so it's very simple. Just go to layer, take a new solid layer, and this is going to be the black background, so you can call it black BZ for black background. You can select black color from here, just like this, hit OK, and now we have the black background. After that, I'm gonna use any image for this project, so just go to this project window, right click on that, go to import file and select any image. So I'm gonna use this image for this project. I will give you a link in the description, so you can download this free image from unsplash.com and use this image for practice in your project. Once you have downloaded, just select the image and click on import. Now I'm going to create an image placeholder for this image, so just go to composition, take a new composition, and this is going to be the media composition where we can drag and drop our image file. So let's call it media, you can call it anything, hit OK. Now let's import the image inside of this media composition, just like this. Now you can adjust the image size and position, so hit P on the keyboard to open this position. I'm gonna set the position of this image just like this. Now it's looking perfect. And after that, you can go to the main composition, and here we have to import the media composition into this main composition. So this is the media composition. Let's drag this image into this main composition over on this black background, just like this, and then hit T on the keyboard to open this opacity, and let's set the opacity maybe 10% or 15%. Set the opacity according to you, hit enter. Now it's looking perfect. After that, we have to create a text over here. This is going to be the bold text, so select the text tool, go to character. If you don't have this character, then go to window and check this option character, and for this text we need to select any bold font style. So in this case, I'm going to use Gobold font style. So this is the Gobold regular font style. I'm going to use this Gobold regular font style, and I will give you a link in the description for these font styles, so you can use this font style for this, but you can select any different font style if you want. Let's set the size of this font 375 pixels. After that, click over here and type whatever you want to type. Now we have to type this text in the capitals, so it's very simple. Hit Ctrl A to highlight all, and you can click on this button, all caps, and make it capital, just like this. And after that, just go to paragraph and check this option, center text. This is the most important thing. And then go to align and align the text in the center. So click on this align horizontally, click on this align vertically. After that, we have to set the anchor point in the center of this text. So it's very simple. Select the move tool, select the text layer, hold control on the keyboard and just double click on this pan behind tool and set the anchor point in the center of this text, just like this. Before we get started, let's take a look at the amazing pack I Want It All bundle from ageuse. This pack includes premium as well as free tools and plugin for After Effects that hopefully increase your production and save you so much time and efforts. Some elements of this pack including seamless transition, shape elements, whiteboard animation, text preset and much more for absolutely free. All the links will be in the description, please check it out. Now select the move tool. After that, we have to set the opacity of this text maybe 10 or 15%. So hit T on the keyboard to bring out the opacity parameter and let's set the opacity 10%. Now we have to create a duplicate of this text layer. So select the trendy text layer, hit Ctrl D to duplicate and this is the second copy and I'm going to use any different font style for the second text copy. So what we have to do, just select the second layer, hit T on the keyboard to open this opacity and let's set the opacity maybe 100%. After that, we have to change the text. So select the text layer, select the text tool, just double click on that and select all the text. And here we have to change the font style. So for this one, we have to select any signature or any cursive font style. So I'm going to use Broetown signature font style. You can use any different signature font style. And now I'm going to use this text in lowercase. So just turn off the all caps button and make it like this. Now it's looking perfect. And then we have to increase the size of this text. So I'm going to set the value 400 pixel. And now we have to align the text in the center. So select the move tool, go to align, click on this align horizontally, click on this align vertically. Basically, we have to set the text in the center. And one more thing, we have to set the anchor point in the center. So it's very simple. Select the second text layer, hold Ctrl on the keyboard, double click on the span behind tool and set the anchor point in the center of this text, just like this. All right, now select the move tool. And we have to animate both the text. So select both the text just like this and then go to 1 second right over here. Hit P on the keyboard to open this position property. Click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe on position property for both the text. Go to on 2 second right over here. Turn on the stopwatch button and lock the value as it is on 2 second. And then go to very first frame of this animation. Just double click on this blank area, select the bold text and let's place the bold text in upper direction just like this and then go to the end of this animation and set the text outside of this frame in lower direction just like this. So now we have this type of animation. After that, we have to animate this text in opposite direction from this bold text. So select the second text, go to very first frame of this animation and for this one we have to drag it down, set the text outside of this frame in lower direction and then go to the end of this animation. Now you have to move the text in upper direction just like this and now you can play the animation. It's looking like this, but this is the linear animation. We have to make it smoother. So what we have to do, select all the keyframes just like this, hit F9 on the keyboard to easy ease them and then go to your graph editor. If your graph editor not looking like this, then right click on that and check this option, edit a speed graph. Select both the handles and drag it like this. You can drag these two handles just a little bit and make it like this. And then do the same thing for these two keyframes. So highlight these two keyframes, just drag it like this, highlight these two keyframes over here and let's set a little bit just like this. Now you can close the graph editor. You can close the layer and go to very first frame and let's take a look. All right, it's looking nice. After that, we have to create a glow effect for this text. So what we have to do, we have to create a duplicate of this text. So select the text, hit Ctrl D to duplicate. So this is the first text, this is the text 2 and this is the text 3. Text 1 is a little different because it's bold character and these two texts are same. Now we have to turn off the visibility of the second text for now and select the top text layer, which is the main text. Go to effect and preset and let's search for glow effect. So this is the glow effect. Let's apply this glow effect on the main text just like this, and we have to increase the glow radius. Let's set the glow radius maybe 100. We have to apply one more glow effect, so let's drag and drop on this effect control. You can close the first glow effect, go to the second glow effect, and let's set the value 400 in glow radius and make it like this. You can close this one. Let's drag and drop another glow effect, and inside of the third glow we have to set the value 800, and now we will get something like this. After that we have to apply fast blur effect, so let's search for fast box blur effect. Let's apply the fast box blur over here and let's increase the blur radius maybe 8. All right, and now it's looking like this, but we need the original texture. So what we have to do, we have to apply CC composite. So this is the CC composite effect. Let's apply the CC composite on the text, and we have to uncheck this option RGB only, and we will get something like this. It's very simple. And after that we have to colorize the text, so we have to take a new adjustment layer. So just go to the layer, go to new and take a new adjustment layer, and this is going to be the color. So right click on this layer, click on rename, call it color, and we have to apply hue and saturation effect on it. So we have to search for hue and saturation. So this is the hue and saturation effect. Let's apply this hue and saturation on this adjustment layer. Check this option colorize. You can increase the saturation and set the saturation value maybe 80%, just like this. And now you can switch the color from color hue value. So you can set any color from here. You can decrease the colorized saturation and set it to 60 maybe, or maybe 75. 75 is better. Now we will get something like this, which is looking very awesome. Now let's add one more effect. So select the third text, open this text layer. Here we have the animate. Let's add opacity, and here we have the opacity. Let's set the opacity 0. Open this arrange selector, go to on frame number 40, maybe 1 second and 10 frame, right over here, and here we have the start. So let's set the start 100. Click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe on a start parameter. Go to on frame number 10, maybe 30 frame back in time, right over here, and let's set the value 0. So we will get something like this. So you can keep it like this, or you can also open the advanced, and here we have the shape. So you can change shape to smooth, and you can get this type of effect, which is looking pretty awesome. All right, now you can close the layer, and now you can turn on the second text layer by clicking on this I button. Hit T on the keyboard. Let's down the opacity and set it to 25%. So we will get a little LED turn off effect just like this. All right, and after that we have to add one more animation on the second text and the third text. So what we have to do, click on this toggle switches and turn on the 3D button for these two texts, and go to the end of this animation. Hit R on the keyboard to open this rotation, and here we have the Y rotation. So click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe on Y rotation for both the text, just like this. And let's set the Y rotation value -30°. Go to very first frame of this animation and set the value 30°. Now you can close the layers, click on fit button, and it's almost done. So just go to very first frame of this animation, go to full screen, and let's have a look. Alright, so it's looking awesome, and that's all for this tutorial. I hope you guys like it. If you like it, then hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell notification for more interesting videos. Also hit the like button for this video. My name is Vikas, and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.